I think that Porsche would be such a good car.
Porsche is good everywhere. They're like, they're probably the most competitive car all round.
Yeah, but they get ate up. I guess when there's tire wear involved, it screws that car up.
I think it was still titled Amateur League.
Oh, well, there goes the Porsche.
Well, I don't know if this is a handling. This is like a combination. Autopolis has, like, every corner you could want ever. I mean, if you look at, let's just take, yeah, the other route is good. Yeah, the 4C dominates and the regular Mugan dominates. Sirocco is next.
I see you took my line there, Paul.
Maybe.
It's quite exciting when you touch the grass, isn't it?
Very exciting.
No, not like that, though.
You had to say it, didn't you?
we're fighting shit off.
Okay, I'm sitting this one out.
Well, let's take a lap here. We'll take a lap with Hollywood.
Daddy, you're a crit.
It's not letting me. Well, this track is one of the few tracks that has every type of curve in it. I love this track, and it's another good testing track. It's got a blind curve in it, which they're putting up to right now. Also, like a half blind curve. It's got a progressive, like 90 degree turn, which they're coming up to right now. And now they're gonna come up with, it's what I call like the tiny spoon. It's got like a spoon curve with Suzuki in it right here. Now it's got a hairpin in it. Next turn they're gonna come up to is a long sweeping, like left hand, like a patient left hand turn. You have to be patient to this turn.
Sit hugely inside until we see the curves on the outside.
I use that floor. Little post, that little guard shaft, whatever you call it. But yeah, the curves are another good one. Then they go into an uphill, downhill, like hairpin. Into what I call, I think this is the hardest turn in Grand Theft Auto, right? What they're doing right there. That it's got to be the absolute hardest turn in the world. And then they're coming up to another, like, turn one at Suzuka type thing, with, like, slower paced at it. And then it shifts back into some, like, partial S's and shit. I'm never gonna get that bitch down of my head.
Hold on, rock and roll.
This track looks like a dinosaur with a tiny dick.
God, now I see it. I see it.
GTR is pretty good around here.
I don't see it.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
I'm a little surprised how good that car is around here.
It's the driver. Oh, shit. It's the driver. It's not the car.
There is something about when you're in that car, magic things seem to happen.
Dude, I think that, personally, I think the GTR is a shit car.
So do I, but... Yeah. And look at Hollywood and...
It just has that speed for a track like this that you can't get up to it at all because there's too many straights that are just that long enough where it just pulls ahead.
Yeah, he almost had to make a couple mistakes for you to get up on.
Like through the corners, like I couldn't do anything. I thought the short wheelbase in the Super would do something, but really it's not.
I can definitely tell tire wear is taking its toll on Hollywood.
What a replica on the field.
Actually, people underestimate the beat. It's a fast car.
No, I'm on about the interior on the inside. Looking at it, well, I'm 3 or 5 in it. You can see the amount of throttle he's actually putting into the car. It's on the dash.
It won't let me look at it. It won't let me change out. Let's see it. Let me try this. There we go. Oh, there's some stuff. well, let me go interior on it. There it goes. That's a weird interior.
Yeah, but the thing in the, what you see in the middle, on the top, it shows how much throttle he's putting into the car. Look at that.
Oh, that is weird. Those two little blue things?
Yeah, that's the throttle.
That's his throttle response. This is throttle response. It's crazy. Let's check out what other interiors we've got.
It's sad that you have to actually go in front there.
Benefit wall. That needs some practice.
The Supra's got a knife inside.
I like how they have rear view cameras.
Yeah.
Woo! What was that?
Hands on the grass!
Oh, I got pushed off.
You definitely got pushed off.
That beetle just sent me straight to the beach. So thank you. You need a goddamn vacation anyway.
Crap, I'm not in last
anymore.
Going into cockpit camera with Holman lights. It just shows you how
he
crazy.
Broke a little early there, didn't he, Holman?
What?
He broke a little earlier than usual.
I don't know what he was doing.
No, I'm talking about the Supra in front of you.
Nah, be me.
I know. I'm the only one that pit.
I pit as well.
We did.
Yes. Yeah, it'd be an undercut sort of pit stop, wouldn't it, for one stop?
It's worth a shot, right? Does no one have their radar on today? Is that what's going on?
Well, we'll find out if I pass Hollywood.
Hollywood just come out, so. Oh, no.
That is gonna be really sketchy on Sunday. People are gonna be storming into that corner.
That's
when people are coming out
of
the pits very slow.
Yeah, no shit.
That's why I was very, like, hesitant when you were going in there, Holman.
I gave you a good extra lane.
I'm not. It wasn't me, mate.
Yeah, no, I made sure to give him a little extra lane. So now I really don't know what the hell's gonna happen. Man.
Well, you did have, like, if that undercut would have worked, you... if that undercut would work, you would have an extra 10 seconds on top of what you got right now.
Yeah. It's nice. That undercut's really nice, especially when you have a lot less fuel in the car. You can go that extra length.
We pitted 2 laps here.
I pitted in lap 6.
One lap really. The undercut should work for you on Sunday. I think, Holman, if you can get another 2 seconds ahead of him, I think you'd be alright. He's in the tire wear 1 mile.
I am a little worried how it took a while to get through. It took a lot longer than it did the last couple of weeks. But this track is a great equalizer.
I love this track. I never even heard about this track before brought on here.
Same.
He's got like a 2 second lead on him right now. The GTR should catch him for like in 3 laps, and then the tire wear after 5 laps, 6 laps. Yeah, I see it. This is the actual Pro League lobby that I set up today. It's the same lobby you guys are going to be running on Sunday. Are you going to be running in the Super Formula League with us? I think TT's trying to get 2 separate days going. So everyone can race. There's going to be like, you can either race like Sunday or Saturday, and then we're going to have like a championship race with the 2 days, the top 8 or something like that, or the top 6 from each, are going to have like a championship race.
Yeah, did you win?
Yes, Mike.
Okay.
No, I think TJ posted in the wrong week. Because the GRT league was actually bottom. Everything else, Gatto runs that league. He's the boss of that league. I know he's been absent for a couple weeks. He's trying to find a job. But it's his league to run. So. And I think TJ was trying to post in the Super Formula League. And then got... Gatto thought he might have been like talking about this a little bit, but he wasn't. I think it was just a misunderstanding. The Super Formula would teach you how to drive every other car. I didn't really get good at Grand Turismo. Like learning how to drive without traction control until I did it in Super Formula. Oh, you guys in your pads, man. Here's what's crazy, man. I spent like $1,000 in cards, man. It's still faster than you. $40 at Walmart. That is true, Lawrence. It does teach you how to react, especially at tracks, aggressive tracks like Suzuka. I use a Fanatec CSL Elite with a load cell. But I interchange, I'll take my load cell off for certain races. Oh, you want to do shop only? A dual shock lead. The load cell feels like a real car. When you put the load cell on, if you're using like old school like M cars, M class cars, you want the load cell. Because it feels like a regular car, you can judge your brakes a lot better. Trail brake that shit ton of other roads. Well, Coleman got past Coleman. I am thoroughly surprised how good that Porsche is doing. I know Goat's fast in general, but I mean he's already zoned against Boomer. Boomer's in the Super, which is an OP car.
Don't forget, I'm on wheel. I have no idea what I'm doing.
Is this your first time on a wheel?
No, but I rarely ever use it. I was doing alright last night, but I'm just sort of taking it easy right now. I'm not actually pushing. I can try getting back on pad and seeing what I can do in the final race.
Are you in the Pro League?
Main death.
I just have the CSL Elite. I'm never coming for it.
Come on, half my head, bye.
Hollywood blow out a tire or something? He's just fishtailing down the straightaway.
He blew out life. Life's not being good to Hollywood right now.
Yeah. Especially if I got past him. Oh, that makes sense.
That's when I normally start drifting. It's more fun.
Who's faster than you? Who would say they're faster than you without load cell?
Calling you out?
Someone was just calling me out, man. Yeah. But if I'm saying I'm sorry, someone just called me out. And now they won't say it in chat again. They won't say it was me.
You ever make an offer about?
No, I'm looking at the chat right now. For ransom. Then I'll eat you up in a suit.
Well done, Holman.
Good job, Holman.